Holy Legos, Batman! The trailer looks sweet.
It's a vlog.
Make sure that's in focus. Yeah, cool. Because I had a problem last time with making sure it's in focus for good lighting. Anyways, hi and see you on CC Films. It's a vlog. New t-shirt! Hooray! So anyways, as you may kind of tell, I made two different new videos lately. One is the Minecraft type video about Windows 8. And plus by that, the second video that I made this week is the Voice Studio for Xbox Live. If you haven't already checked these videos out that I made this week. So as you kind of tell by the quality of the mic and plus maybe a bit of background noise. But I finally got my mic fixed. Hooray! Hey! Funny you should say how I found out about it, because I looked on the mic, the little tiny hole on the mic on my iPod Touch 4G, and basically it was just a little bit of guff. Because I always have my stuff in my pocket all the time, because the stuff that I have in my pocket kind of made a little bit of guff into the mic, and it kind of got blocked off for the past few months, and that's why I had to use this, where is it? Ah, here it is. This little mic attachment to do my videos on, and now I don't need this kind of no more. Until maybe if I got a bit of guff in it again, that means I have to clean it out with a little safety pin and all that. But for now, I'm making sure that basically I put my iPod in this iPod sock to make sure that basically it does not get any guff or any type of nasties when it's in my pocket and all that, and making sure that the mic is clean for and to do with the videos. And sorry in case you hear any like quality redemption or background noise or out of sync with basically when my iPod overheats when I'm doing a really really long vlog and editing it all out, it kind of goes out of sync a bit. I just want to say sorry about that, guys. Now, even though I don't usually play indie games from the indie game marketplace on Xbox Live, but I played one recently this week, which was Avatar Deathmatch, which came out on the indie game marketplace this week. And I gotta say, it's not bad of a first person shooter game, because it's a cartoon first person shooter game. It comes with one map, and basically it's like a cartoony sort of game, which I kind of find interesting. I would pay the 240 Microsoft points for the multiplayer, however, but it's not my sort of willing to pay that more, some more Microsoft points. It's sort of like an online pass sort of thing. You can download it for free, the free trial, and basically you can free roam the map and all that, which is kind of nice. But if you wanted to get the full online experience, you had to pay the, 240 Microsoft points. I don't usually play much indie games, but I know that basically, they got some really cool games on the indie marketplace, and I should actually play more. I know all my US friends, however, my US pals, they usually play on like Total Miner, that is like a copycat version of Minecraft and all that. And I would like to try some more, because I also tried this Mercs vs Zombies type game, which is another first person shooter game for 240 Microsoft points. And it's really graphical for an indie game sort of thing. Speaking about Xbox Live, recently there's been some technical issues on Xbox Live recently. First of which is the zero gamer score glitch that's been happening. A few of my friends who've got like a decent amount of gamer score and recently resetted it to zero gamer score, and then later on throughout the week it got back to its normal amount of gamer score. And it's funny though, because one of my friends who is the legendary Adam Rose, who's got like 70k gamer score, and basically it resetted it to zero, and he was a bit peed off because basically he missed out on them because he has 100%ed Burnout Paradise and all that, and he was like, angry as girls, how does this happen? But it recently later on got reset it back, not to zero, but back up to his normal gamer score, and he's quite pleased to have his gamer score back. And most of my other friends have got like the same problem, and then later on it recently resetted it back to its normal game score limit. Also, another thing that's happened on Xbox Live lately, which is a kind of an incident that I had this week. Recently I sent a message to someone, yeah, I bet you watch this right now, you know who you are. And basically, I sent a message to someone on Xbox Live, and I was sending them a message saying something, and basically, I waited a bit, and I waited for like a day, and basically, I didn't get no reply, because this person was online, and I thought she would quick reply to me, you see. But then, it was like a day, and I thought, like, why is this person not replying to me? And then, I sent them a message again, saying, have you got my message and all that? And then the person sent a message back saying that, what message? And basically, I had a bit of a problem with the first message that I sent. So there's been some message errors lately on sending messages on Xbox Live. Not because I've gone over the 100 limit from sending everyone a message on my friends list. It's just I just thought I'd just send a message while I've not had gone over the 100 limit. You see, so I've been like raging on Tumblr and Facebook and Twitter lately, on the internets lately, all about all this drama over this message reply and all that. But I think it's all sorted now, I think. But in case you have been having any issues on Xbox Live, but yeah, there's been some issues on Xbox Live. So for the past week, this week, this bug lugs, however, has been a bit spoiled lately, only because some point this month it will be his birthday at March 29th, and it'll be 21 this year, and I don't blame him, because it is his 21th, and basically 21st, and basically it is it's a big moment in life and all that. And recently he got like some new stuff lately, he got some pickups, and basically, as you may not know, a few vlogs ago he recently got a new Xbox, because of his Xbox has been broken, and recently he got a new Xbox early, as an early birthday present. And then he got another early present, and he spent £30 on a contract at the moment, and basically a monthly contract sort of thing. And he recently got an iPhone 3GS. And when he first got this, he's loving it to death, and as you can see right now, he's basically loving it even more, because he doesn't usually use much of the iOS system, and when he first got this, he's loving the, you know, experience of the iOS system. As you may know me, however, I just use the good old Windows phone, but I love my iPod to death on doing all my you know, Facebook, Twittering, and all my checking my messages, checking my comments and all that, and I love doing it on my iPod. It would be cool though if I had the iPad, that way it makes the but there's no way that I can fit in my pocket while I'm out and about in town, so I'd rather have an iPod anyways. But still, however, he's loving the whole iOS experience, and he's loving all the kind of cool games you can get on it, because he downloaded this Game Loft game, which is £5, and basically it does like a monthly subscription fee, which is an MMO, and because my friend Cam, he loves MMORPGs, then he got this game which has an MMO sort of style, and it's really, really cool, he said to me. Plus, other than that, he's got also a Capcom-related game, which is Monster Hunter, because he really wants to play Monster Hunter on back on the PS2, and he asked me if there was a particular app on iOS, and I said, oh yeah, there is a Monster Hunter game on the iOS, and he got that as well on his iPhone as well. And also, not that, speaking about games and all that, he also got some pickups from GameStation since the whole, you know, Game and GameStation sales and all that. I mentioned that on the last vlog. But because of that, he spent a few couple of quids they had and got a load of games from GameStation, which I'm going to go through now. Sorry, the reason why I had to hum in the background, because I do not know how to put music in the background on Roxy at the moment. But yeah, so he's bought a load of games, as you can see. I've played a few on them. I played like Quake 2 on the bonus disc on Quake 4, and plus I played a bit of Lost Planet 2, and I might, however, maybe play a bit of Fight Night Round 3, because I saw Cam play on it, and looks like a really cool boxing game, and plus you can get some, you know, easy G's on Fight Night Round 3 as well. And then speaking about easy G's, I, however, got myself a pickup as well this week, and I was meaning to try and get this game for a while, because even though it's like a 2.5, was it 2.5 sort of game, and basically it's one of those sort of games, well, it is Dead Rising 2 off the record. And as you can see right here, it used to be £10 and it used to be £8, but I was looking up, looking enough to get this for £5.50 because I had £2.50 on my game card, and basically I got this for £5.50. And yeah, and even though it's a 2.5 debt thing, as most games usually do, and plus it's cash com as usual, but it has got some really cool easy G's, and I've been playing on the sandbox mode, and basically you don't have to have like a time limit, you can do whatever the hell you want comparing it to Dead Rising 2. But yeah, I think it's a well deserved pickup if you find this for really, really cheap, and plus get a discount for it like I did on my game loyalty card and all that. So I picked myself this game up and been playing a load of these games that Cam got lately this week. Also, even though that Cam got a load of games in this week, mostly he's been playing on Call of Duty, because I don't know why, he's been like, he got all these games and then he's just play on Call of Duty. And the funny thing is, as you may not know, he recently got an arm broken, like I mentioned in the last vlog, and so he's been calling it a COD arm because he's been playing a lot of Call of Duty too much, and maybe that's why it caused that nerve blockage, as I mentioned in the last vlog. Plus, not only that, I just want to quickly mention that Cam would like maybe to get the Call of Duty Elite Pass. He said that he was thinking of getting, and basically, I just want to quickly mention the cheapest way to get it, if you find one for £30. And you can get the 4,000 Microsoft points card. You can get the full on Call of Duty Elite Pass. And plus, for those people that haven't got the Call of Duty Elite Pass, the collection pack will be coming out sooner or later, which will cost about 1,200 Microsoft points. So do shop around and try and find a cheap Call of Duty Elite card, which is 4,000 Microsoft points. And basically, you might find a cheaper one for like £30 in your local stores and all that. Ooh, enough about Cam for one day. So anyways, what I've been up to lately. Well, I've been to work recently, been a bit boring in the office this week. And it'd be, you know, St. Patrick's Day today. And I'm wearing my green hat and I'll be wearing it all day. I pinched you. You're not wearing green. So yeah, it's been St. Patrick's Day today, depending on what type of what time you'll be watching this vlog. And plus only that, tomorrow on Sunday, it'll be Mother's Day, so I've got my Mother's Day card all ready and prepared for tomorrow. So anyways, what are you doing, Cam?
I don't know, I got stuck.
Cam! Do you smell?
No, I'm alright.
Nope. Careful, Yam. So, what videos I'll be doing next week? I'm not so sure what videos I'll be doing next week, but whatever that I'll do for you guys, and then do a vlog afterwards. So, anyways, that is my vlog for you guys. Hope you really enjoyed. Do not forget to follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Have a nice weekend. Have a nice St. Patrick's Day for all your Irish people out there. I know that sounds a bit weird. But anyways, and hope you have a great Mother's Day on Sunday. Anyways, I better go now. See you from CT Films.